The Dominican Winter League is usually known to be really hard for batters, but Eric Filia has figured out a way to be successful at the plate. Ever since he came to Escogido to reinforce them for the round robin, once Estrellas Orientales were disqualified, he has managed to hit a 420 average, and it's now considered the hardest out in the league. I met with Filia today at the field, and he gave me some tips and tricks to use at the plate, just to show me how is it like to be the hottest hitter in the planet right now. So follow me now as we come to train with Eric Filia. Ready with?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it. I'm gonna grab my glove. Eric, this is your first time in the Dominican League. Before you came here, did you like talk to anybody about it? And what did they tell you?
Actually I talked to a few people. Actually Castillo was one of them. And Avelino was one of them. Just to get like an idea, and then one of my good friends, Chuck Taylor, he played in the Venezuelan League and Mexico, and just had to get an idea, and he said it was so much fun, so much passion, and that's what I'm all about. Is I love big crowds, I love fans, you know. So when I heard about this, I couldn't like pass it up. So it's been a great experience, and very glad I came out here.
It's really cool that you got to experience two teams in the same. When did they explain that to you? Like once the Estrellas were not going anymore, you will be able to play for another team, or how was that process for you?
Yeah. So Evan McClain told me about it because he's been here for 13 years. So and he's played for different teams, and so. When I found that out, I thought it was a pretty neat experience. I bummed that Estrellas didn't make it, of course. That was my number one team. I got another opportunity here to keep playing for Escolito, and they're a great team and great fan base. And so, it's been a pretty wild experience.
How do you get to play here in the first place? Like, who talked to you to come? Who offered you to come? Or what's in your part? You say you want to come. How was that?
So Manny Acta, since he's one of our coaches for the Seattle Mariners, I talked to him during spring training, and he's the GM for Estrellas. So me and him kept talking, and he thought it would be a great opportunity for my family and I. To play and make some money and kind of get exposure and see what I'm capable of doing. So, he gave me the opportunity to keep playing, he was the big influence on why I came out here.
So, Dominican League is known because it's hard to hit in it. It's a lot of good pitchers, and we have like players from every kind of level. They have major leaguers, Mexico League.
Right.
But you figured it out very well. So what's the secret? What's the hitting?
I don't think there's really a I don't think there's really a secret. The talent here is second to none. You got good players all across the board. Even the players that don't start, they're impact players with different teams. So I just don't try to change who I am. Try to stay with my approach, the fields are big here. Ball doesn't go anywhere, which is kind of tough to hit, especially for the player that I am. I just try to, find holes, stick with my approach, and try to do as best as I can, really.
I know you've been hitting pretty well, but is there one specific pitcher that you are still trying to figure out?
OK,
pitcher?
Yeah.
There's this one lefty, Diego Alvarez, I believe his name is, for Santiago.
Aguilas.
Yeah, okay. Aguilas. He's got a beard, lefty reliever. Me and him had our battles this whole year, basically. And he's a really good pitcher, left on left. He's sneaky. And finally got him last time we faced him. And so it was like my first hit off him in like 8 at-bats, 10 at-bats. But again, everybody here is really good. You know, they control their stuff for strikes, off speed, fastball, everything. So, I mean, and the thing here is that they come after you, you know? If they have a good pitch or they have high velocity, I mean, they're not afraid to show you it. So I kind of like that, you know, it's like mano-a-mano, one-on-one.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of the, competition I like to feel when I'm in the box, and their demeanor out on the mound is one-on-one, you know? So it's, I like that feeling.
So I saw this video of a little kid down in San Pedro imitating your batting stance, but what is it? You have like a little dance before the batting stance,
So
I'm here for that. So what is it? Show me.
So I've had this like routine ever since high school.
Okay.
And then in college, I was influenced by a gentleman named Ken Revisa. Passed away a couple years ago, but he had a very big impact on my career about the mental side of the game and how baseball can be very routine based. So, you know, I walk up and I do my routine, and then about 2 years ago, my whole shimmy started just as a a breather, you know, just trying to loosen up because I wasn't doing so well and I had to change something and just trying to breathe and relax. So,
and then you stick around?
And then it got into, I started doing very well, and then it got into what it is now of the whole dance ordeal.
So everybody do you have like a specific song for it, or?
No, I mean my walkout song. I like my walkout song, so.
Does it change every year, or is it the same one?
It's been the same for the last 2 years, 3 years. I kind of like a little hype thing, but it's my routine based. I take pride in it, so I feel very confident in it, and that's a big influence or big reason why I do it.
Okay, so that's what we're here for. So Eric is gonna give me some hidden lessons. I suck at baseball, but let's go. So, talk me through it.
So, my routine, you know, when you see me like in the box and I look at my bat, so I try to find a spot on my bat and just to like clear my mind and breathe, because one of the biggest things that hitters do is think. You know, they overthink. So, when I find something on my bat that I can focus on and just clear my head and breathe. And the biggest thing when I say breathe is many people rush it, you know, rush their breath or rush their routine. My biggest thing is you gotta finish your breath. So when I look at the bat and I breathe, I try to exhale everything, you know? So I just clear my mind, and then that's when I step in and it's just me and him, you know? So that's one of the biggest, one of my biggest things that I do.
So that's the main thing when you go into the box?
Yeah, that's my main
thing. Do you give them like a mean look, like, gotcha? No.
No. No, it's just, I got my job to do, and he's got his job to do. So again, it's that competition feeling that you have. That's what makes this game so much fun.
What do you do when you're at the box to tune out the noise, because I know you play in AAA over there, But coming here is just a whole different animal. Like, it's crazy. Like, it's crazy because if it's full, it's packed, you can hear that.
Right.
And if there's not many people, there's like two guys that you can hear all the way through the game. So.
So I was actually very fortunate to go to the College World Series in 2012 and 2013 with UCLA. And we were playing in front of 28, 30,000 people. And we had our little fan base of about 300 people.
Wow.
Yeah, so, but no, that experience with the fans, you know, of being on you and the pressure and the atmosphere, it's kind of prepared me for my professional career. I mean, hopefully one day I make it to the big leagues and understand a big league, you know, stadium and atmosphere like that. But no, again, like what you asked me, what I need to do to block out all the noise is, again,
look at the bat.
Look at the bat, breathe, and it's kind of like tunnel vision, you know, like me and the pitcher. Nothing else matters at that point.